just when you think the media's reputation can't get any worse, this happens. Now, before we begin the video today, I'd like to ask you to comment, like, and share. And if you're not a normal viewer here at Logic Over Emotion, consider hitting that subscribe button. We'd love to have you as part of the channel because here we bring the hard truth while others are busy virtue signaling. All right. Now, when I initially saw the title of this article, I wasn't even going to make a video. The title was Trump, Americans Who Died in War Are Suckers and Losers, or something to the extent. I was like, really? No one is going to actually believe this. However, I decided to do one because recently there was a short discussion in the comments of one of my videos, and we were talking about what the Democrats would actually cook up, next to try to take Trump down. And I came to the conclusion that they would blatantly make up stories with no credible sources and pass it off as true, which is exactly what this article is. Now, before we dive further into it, I want to make it apparent that there were many mentions of sources in the article. However, due to them needing to be anonymous, they were unnamed. Now, of course, that's very convenient, so just keep that in mind as we go through this. So the article starts off by saying the president has repeatedly disparaged the intelligence of service members and asked that wounded veterans be kept out of military parades. Multiple sources tells The Atlantic. So you can see the point of the article already, right? They're going after Trump and his so-called lack of support for our military and wounded heroes. Now, this is an odd approach to me, considering Trump has been pro-military and pro-law enforcement, and you see it in his day-to-day actions. Now, has Trump had disagreements with certain service and intelligence members? Absolutely, but we are allowed to disagree. To set the framework, Trump had said some pretty negative things about John McCain. I believe he had said something along the lines of, you know, I like people who don't get captured. And that statement was in reference to McCain spending more than 5 years as a prisoner of North Vietnamese. Now, where all of this starts to go sideways is when they start making some very outlandish claims. For instance, the article said that when McCain died in August of 2018, Trump told his senior staff, according to three sources with direct knowledge of the event, that they were not going to support that loser's funeral. And he, you know, became furious, according to witnesses, when he saw the flags lowered to half staff. Now, Trump has come out and said this was an outright lie. He said, even though him and McCain didn't see eye to eye, he still respected him as a man, as a human being. And in fact, he went out of his way to make sure the funeral was supported and had what it needed. Now, there's a few more examples, or rather made up stories, in the article that attempts to further push the agenda. I'll link the article in the description and you can read it in its entirety when you have time. I wanted to take a few moments, though, and talk about what this really means. I mean, it seems that journalism isn't journalism anymore. It isn't about the truth. We have countless examples of Trump supporting our military and our law enforcement. My dad even gave Trump praises for, you know, raising the money that veterans receive. My father's retired Army. In fact, my dad also said Obama didn't do anything for the military and wasn't at all concerned with the veterans. And, you know, at this point, it's almost like we should just take whatever the lamestream media says, flip it, and you would have the truth. And again, the left is miscalculating how this is going to play out. Sure, their base is going to eat this up, but those with a few more brain cells will question what they see versus what they're hearing. And it doesn't take much effort to see that Trump has been very good to our military. Remembering now, we are at a point where we have Democratic mayors coming out and endorsing Trump. We have police unions endorsing Trump. We have people who have voted Democrat their entire life endorsing Trump. And now, all of a sudden, we are supposed to believe that he cares nothing about our military and fallen heroes. You know, the left has lost all their dignity. The left is also extremely confused. They have no clear plan. They have no way of dealing with Trump because their worst fear came true, and that's the fact that Trump is an amazing president with the accomplishments to back it up. He's very good at it. He's so good at it, they are literally having to outright lie and claim a bunch of anonymous sources. Just like the riots have turned more people conservative, so will this. If the left would just stop and listen, one of the main reasons people are turning away from them is because it's become so apparent that they are no longer objective. I watched a walkaway video yesterday or the day before, and the young lady said that, you know, them calling Trump racist over and over again had something to do with her decision. It's too easy today to check whether or not something is an actual fact or just an opinion piece. Also, because the media has lied so much, people just aren't buying it anymore. I do wonder what the left will do now, because there isn't much further you can actually go than the outright lying. And that's clearly what it is, but you guys let me know what you think down below. Go read the article. I'd love your feedback. They were very bold in this one, and I think they just made a costly mistake. Well, that's going to be it for this one. Make sure to comment, like, and subscribe. You guys take care.